Hey, good day, happy honeybees. So today we are on Roblox Club Roblox because I'm showing you guys how to get the Madeiverse Champions event weekly chest on the game Club Roblox because this is basically, so the Madeiverse Champions, if you don't already know, it's like a new Roblox event. And how it works is every week there are multiple games that have like, they're participating in the event, and Club Roblox is one of those games. And so on Club Roblox, you can earn a chest every week. And if you earn all four chests, I'm pretty sure that you get like a prize of some sort. If you guys want to learn more about the event, you can go to the Roblox homepage and then click on events, and then it'll tell you guys about the events. But today I'm showing you guys how to earn the chest from Club Roblox. And it's really fun, it's really simple, and make sure to watch until it ends so you know exactly how to do it. And if you love Roblox and also games like Star Stables, Sims 4, fun games like that, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you don't miss a video, because we do a lot of premieres here. So yeah, you don't want to miss those. But anyways, let's get started with the video. So the first thing you want to do is you want to click on the map and you want to go to like the neighborhood area. And currently I'm in the neighborhood right now. And when you are in the neighborhood, so right now I'm by Blockia, and I'm also by like this area. So you want to turn over here and kind of by like this fishing area over here. You'll notice that there's this area over here called Madeiverse Champions. Oh, and by the way, this video is for the week one chest, and every week there will be a new chest, I'm pretty sure, and I'm not sure if it's going to be different on how you earn it, but this is for week one. So if you are watching it on the day that this is being like premiered, then it should still work. But if it's the next week, then I will release another video for that if it's different. But anyways, you want to go over here, and this is the portal area, and you can just walk in right here, and then it'll teleport you to the Madeiverse Champions like room and stuff. And so over here, as you guys can see, you'll spawn in this area, and there's like this railroad track, and like it's like really cool. Everything's like glowing, and like it's just super awesome. But you go down here and just follow these glowing arrows, and there's just like this room that you'll basically come in. And the first thing you want to do is you want to go over here and you want to go talk to this person. I'm pretty sure I think that you get this avatar bundle if you complete all 4 weeks of the chest. So again, this is week one, and I'm pretty sure you have to get the chest every week for 4 weeks to get it. But again, I'm not 100% sure. You can check out the Roblox events page and go to Madeiverse Champions, and you can read more info there. But anyways, you want to come over here and click chat, and then Sparks Kilowatt, I hope I said that right, it says, hey, help me by completing all 6 puzzle rooms to unlock the chest and a special pet. So yeah, you guys also get a free pet on here for completing the week one chest. So that also is another benefit of doing this, and again, it's really simple and easy. So the first thing you want to do is go over here into this, and it's gonna say one, and it's gonna like the red, so you notice all the rooms like the little red thingy. That's okay, it means you haven't done it yet basically. When you do it, it'll turn green. So you want to follow the arrows into the first room, and then it's going to take you into the room. And now the task is jump across the moving logs to reach the golden door. So you'll see this kind of is like that one epic mini game where it's like you have to like jump across the river. It kind of reminds me of that, but I thought that was cool. But anyways, just basically just hop on the logs and you can just walk across and then jump back. And then you just have to do this for all of these rivers. There's 3 of them in total. So this is the last one, and we did it. It's pretty easy parkour in my opinion. So I think, and if you do fall, I'm pretty sure you just go back to the beginning and you just restart. So it's okay if you fall. And anyways, now once you've done that, so as you can see, we've done those 3. Over here is the finish door, and just walk in and then you've completed room 1. So there are 6 rooms that we need to complete, and I'll be showing you guys how to do all of those. So as you can see, we spawn back right here in the beginning, or the area where we came, you know, from the railroad track. And so now, if you go back to room 1, you'll see that there's a little green thing. That means that we've completed it. So now we can follow the glowing arrows again, and here is room 2. And again, it has the red thing because we haven't completed it yet. So we're gonna walk in, and this one is a little bit different. So with this one, it is, you have to, so over here the task, you have to find the correct code to unlock the door. So basically you want to go over here to these glowing things, and you want to spin this, And then when it turns green, that thing in the middle, it means you've done the correct one. So don't touch this again, like once it turns green. And so these two are currently pink, which means that we need to do this. So you want to click spin and see it's not green. So you want to do it again. And then now it's green, so we don't need to do it again. So these two are good now. So we only got one more left. And you want to click spin. And it's not green yet, so we're going to click spin again. And again, it's not green, so we're going to click spin again. And now it's green, so now you've completed it. And then the door will open, and so we can go to the finish door. And so now you've completed room 2. So now on to room 3. So again, with room 2, you can see this green. So again, follow the glowing arrows. And you want to head into room 3. And room 3 is you have to find the 3 hidden keys to unlock the door. So it's kind of like you gotta, there are 3 different keys around the room. So the first key is over here. So you want to walk over here, and there are like these boxes, and it's in here. There's one key, and you just go over here and click collect. And then you have that one key. So now there are 2 more keys. So the second key is located by doing just some jumps, and they're pretty simple jumps. So it's like it won't take you very long. So you just jump across these jumps, and then you will be over here. And then there's the second key. And so you can you can collect the second key. And so the final key, you just hop off that, is over here by this river area. And you just want to hop on the stones. Well, you technically don't need to, but I think it's kind of fun. And then you can collect that. So now you've collected all 3 keys, so you can head back over here. And the door is open, so then you just want to go through there. And then you'll be done with room 3. I think this is room 3. I'll double check. So we just got done with room 3, yeah. So as you can see, we're done with this side. So we've gotten room 1, room 2, and room 3, all of the green things. So we're all done with those. So now we're going to head over to this side. This side has room 4, 5, and 6. And then the final room, this is where like you redeem your prize. But so now we got to go to room 4. And in this room, it's you have to complete a maze. And so I'm pretty sure the maze is the same for everyone, because I think it's not like one of those ones where like the event changes for everyone. So I'm pretty sure, so just head over here. So right, we just went down the entrance ladder, and you want to come over here and walk down here. And then I'm pretty sure you go over here and then head down. This is a pretty easy maze. Again, it's like not too big. And then you go down here, and then there are 2 ways. You want to go the way that has the crystal down here. It's like glowing, and then head this way, and then head down here. And so you want to skip this room, and you want to skip like this little maze area. You want to go down here, and this is the end of the maze, and here's a ladder. And you can tell it's different from the original first ladder because it has the arrow pointing up. So that's how you know that you didn't like accidentally do a circle. And so we made it to the end of the maze, and here's the finishing door. So that is how to do the maze. Again, it's not very tricky, and so it shouldn't take you that long, because I know I'm not good at mazes like whatsoever, and that one took me only 3 minutes honestly to figure out. So it's a pretty easy maze. So now we're on to room 5. We are almost done. We only have room 5 and then room 6, and then we get to our prize. So the task for this one is to complete the obstacle course to reach the golden door. So this one is kind of just like an obby, really. So you just want to hop across this, and if you fall, it's no big deal. You just walk over here and you can go up this little ramp, and then you can start again. So like your avatar doesn't have to respawn. So you just jump across these. They're just kind of just pillar jumps, like this was called. I'm not sure what the exact parkour names are, since I don't play obbies a ton. So now here's like these mushrooms. Again, just jump on them. Like, look how cute these mushrooms are, though. They're really cute. So just jump across those. And then over here, it's kind of similar to that room with the key. Just jump across these jumps like this. And there you go. And then, so now over here, we just gotta walk across these wooden planks across and just try not to fall. And then once you're done with that, you're done with this room. So then go through the finishing door. And then we're on to the final room. We're on to room 6, which is the final room. And as you guys can see, we are done with room 5, 4, all the greens. So that's how you know. So this is the final room with the red. So for this one, you have to cross the bridges to reach the golden door. And this is the final room. So this one, it's a little bit tricky because the bridges move a little bit. So you wanna, the first bridge, you just walk across and then jump. So for these, just jump onto this one and jump onto this one. So now for this one, you want to wait and make sure that the bridges are kind of close to each other before you jump. So like, oh, that was like a really close call, but like you want to jump when they're close to whatever you want to jump onto. So like, for example, this one's just moving back and forth, so you can jump on it whenever and then jump on this one. And just kind of like, honestly, it's kind of just like guessing when it's the right time to jump. And it's okay if you fall again, you can just try again. It's just really you just really just gotta keep trying. And then like, I don't think that they will get far apart like enough where you can't jump, but again, just try to jump when they're kind of close together, you know, so that you can make the jumps. But now you're at the finishing door, so you can finish. And then we're all done with all of the rooms. As you can see, room one has the green, room two is the green, room three has a green, and then room four, room five, room six are all green. And you can tell because they're all kind of glowing, you know, so you already did them. So now we can go into this room, which is at the back, and it has like those six green things. I think they might be crystals, I'm not really sure. And it will have this little chest logo by it, and it's right across from the like the entrance. So you want to come over here and walk through this door, and this is where you get to redeem the chest and the pet. So you want to first go to Sparks Week 1, the chest, and collect it. So just click on it, collect, and then you'll also get a badge. And yeah, it'll say congratulations and you'll get the badge. So that's how you know you collected it. And then it won't be there anymore after you collect it, because that's how you know you've collected it. And then you also get a gem dragon. Like, look how cute this pet is. So just come over here and click adopt. And it is a completely free pet. So like, it's completely free because you completed the rooms, and that's like your prize, you know? So here's our really cute pet. Let's go ahead and pick it up. Look how cute it is. Oh, it's a little gem dragon. Look how adorable it is. It's so cute. Like, look how cute it is. It's just such a cutie pie. It is so worth it for the rooms, because again, it doesn't take very long and you get such a cute pet. And again, it's limited. So, and I'm not sure if there's gonna be a different pet next week, but make sure to come back next week so you can see. But anyways, that is how you complete the Metaverse Champion. So the final step is to go over here and just exit the event so that you have completed it, and then that's all you have to do, and then you're all done with the event for week one. So yeah, let's just wait for it to finish loading, and I'm pretty sure, yep, it takes you back to the it takes you back to I think, what world is this? I think this is maybe the shops, I'm not exactly sure, but it'll take you back here. But anyways, that is it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. If this helped, make sure to hit that like button, and also subscribe if you love Roblox and fun games like that, and make sure to hit that bell so that you get notified whenever we upload a video, because we do premieres and you don't want to miss it. So yeah, and also make sure to stay tuned for next week, because I will be posting another video next week for week two on how to complete this for the Metaverse Champions, because I'm pretty sure it might be different like rooms and stuff, so I'll definitely do a tutorial on how to do that and stuff. So yeah, make sure to stay tuned for that, and I'll probably post it around Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, because that's usually when I post the most videos. So yeah, anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys all have an amazing day. Anyways, bye you guys.